In 2001, 10 years after they formed, Elbow released their debut album, Asleep in the Back. It was nominated for a Mercury Music Prize.
Even now, you see them doing, like, Newborn, and you just look and you think, this is really staggering, but it was staggering when it came out 10 years ago.
Complex, innovative compositions like Little Beast revealed Guy Garvey's uneasy relationship with his hometown of Bury in Lancashire. When these songs came out, what did people in Bury think? They think you were letting them down or betraying them, or...?
Certain people did, but certain people agreed with me as well. I mean, it's in such a beautiful part of the world. Mm. You drive 2 minutes and you're in the most lovely countryside, and it's got a strong, positive history to the place. Plenty to be proud of, but at that time, it was the general sacking of the north of England during Margaret Thatcher's reign. It was just... she did her best to pull apart community in the north. I was sort of the first generation to grow up in it. Some of the lyrics of Little Beast, all of the lyrics of Little Beast, are describing how it feels to be one of those people. You get out into the hills, and it struck me one day as I was driving to Cone, where my mother grew up, that there was a main street coming off the hill with little cul-de-sacs of terraced houses, and it actually looked like a spine going over the hill. And I wrote it into Little Beast, the whole town's dripping down the hill like the spine of something dead. And it goes into the mentality of somebody. The chorus is, fear is not respect, correct, but it's the best you're going to get. I honestly believe that going out and terrorising people to get their fear is the closest thing that you can get to respect sometimes. If you can't get people's respect because there's not necessarily anything you can do that you would be proud of, you'll settle for their fear. And I think that's a lot of the young men that I grew up around. But not me. After the Seldom Seen Kid did really well last year and won lots of awards, we were granted the freedom of Bury, along with film director Danny Boyle. And it was a really lovely sort of family day, going and picking up a certificate and a medal and being appreciated by the borough after not always being that complimentary about the place.
I don't think Bury was half as bad as we made out, or as Guy made out, calling it a shithole that time. You know, we turned all right, turned out all right. We still live round here. I'm quite happy to bring my kids up round here. I think it's good. It's close to Manchester, the best city in the world. What more do you want? I didn't really have a problem with it at all. Guy had a problem with the world. Guy was a 17-year-old stroppy frontman. He had a problem with everything.
It's amazing, really, that five blokes from a mill town with no mills, where, you know, traditionally you are blokey, and you do go to the pub and you do go to football. Amazing that the five of us found each other and started writing this earnest romantic music, because it's a... something perhaps I wouldn't share with somebody else if I haven't met them and known it was okay to do so. Yes, I live off the mirrors and smoke. It's a joke, a fix and lie. Come on.
Oh!
This is something my mum said. My mum said she thought I was allowing blokey blokes somewhere to go and be upset or be in love, be emotional. Very proud of that, if that's the case, you know. The person's a tall, gentle boy to a terrible totem. Kids gather around trying to see what's inside. I think when he's drinking, he's drowning some riots. What is my friend trying to hide? I know the music that the boys write, I find incredibly stirring. The attention to the details and the moves are always to evoke emotion. The things that the five of us find beautiful in music, the common ground, the stuff we write, it's because all the other four tick in a similar way to I do.
The view is of Strange Ways Prison, which is very nice. You would have seen them on the roof there, whenever that was.
Chris was the youngest member of Elbow. He was still at school when he joined the band to play keyboards. He's now the band's producer.
We recorded quite a lot of the Seldom Seen Kid in here. Some vocals were often done here in the stairwell. This is quite a nice place for recording drums. Sometimes I prefer it to the big room we've got. Yeah. And we used to hit that there. That's I think that's on Audience with the Pope, actually, as one of the percussion parts. The classic radiator scrape. Yeah, we've always experimented with sound. We've never really been the band that, you know, members of the band say, no, I'm the keyboard player, so I will... Where's the keyboards on this song? Or, you know, I'm the guitar player and there needs to be... Well, I haven't played guitar yet. And it's like, it's not necessarily... It's all about what's right for the song, and quite often we... Someone comes up with an idea for a sound and it's like, right, let's go out and try and find it, you know, somewhere. It doesn't have to be on instruments that, or even on an instrument, you know. So, for example, here's I've got Weather to Fly up here.